halfway around the world from his native Africa, Tarzan answers a desperate call to rescue natives of Brazil, besieged by an ancient killer cult, spreading death and destruction by fire and poison claw. Thousands enslaved to mine diamonds. In the savage warriors' quest to rule the jungles, in homage to their god, the Jaguar.
Now here, swab the deck. Everybody works on my boat.
Tell your people that the jungle belongs to Barcoon.
Tarzan, fighting his way upriver. Undertaking incredible tasks that tax his tremendous strength to the breaking point. Tarzan, fearless and single-handed, explodes into action and tackles overwhelming odds.
Houdini, who pitted his nerve and skill against the bars and locks of a thousand jails.
I'll admit that Scotland Yard has the finest police brains in the world, but these old sardine cans you call jails are no challenge to the great Houdini.
The fantastic Houdini, who dared impossible odds to release himself from the terrifying depths of an ice-bound river.
After Kowalski.
And there goes the Challenger, being chased by the glue meanies on wheels.
Everybody wants a piece of his hide.
Like anything you want.
The vicious, fat, squad cars are after our lone driver.
They want to put him away, but they'll have to catch him first. It's the maximum trip at maximum speed. Vanishing Point, rated GP.
Famed columnist Hedda Hopper says,
"The Longest Day is a brilliant picture that every woman and man will remember as long as courage, sacrifice, and love of freedom remains in the hearts of men."
In the entire history of the screen, nothing has approached Darrell F. Zanuck's The Longest Day in size, in scope, in suspense, in dramatic intensity. This is the day that changed the world, when history held its breath. 42 internationally renowned stars, one of the greatest casts ever assembled, bring this fateful day to life. Here are some of them: Richard Burton, Paul Anka, Robert Wagner, Richard Beamer, Fabian, Sal Mineo, Jeffrey Hunter, Tommy Sands, Rod Steiger, Edmund O'Brien, Robert Ryan, Mel Ferrer, Kurt Jurgens, Irina Demick, Peter Lawford, Stuart Whitman, Red Buttons, Eddie Albert, Henry Fonda, Robert Mitchum, John Wayne. One of the great films of all time. In years to come, the stature of great screen achievements will be measured against Darrell F. Zanuck's The Longest Day.
These are the armies of the night. The Furies, the Boppers, the Lizzies, the Hi-Hats, the Rogues, the Riffs.
Riff! Yeah!
These are the Warriors. They're from Coney Island.
Sinbad.
27 miles behind enemy lines.
It's the only choice we got.
Between them and safety stand 20,000 cops and every gang in the city. They've got one way out. They've got one chance. They've got one night. The Warriors, rated R.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen in Radio Land.
Oh, Jesus.
In the 1930s, there was a place where dreams came true. It was the most exciting, most wonderful, most glamorous place on earth.
93, take five.
Hollywood.
Run! All right, action!
Paramount Pictures presents The Day of the Locust. An unforgettable vision of love, success, and dreams.
Sometimes I wish I could tear it all down.
In the 1930s, they came to Hollywood in search of a dream. From the writer, producer, and director of Midnight Cowboy, this is The Day of the Locust, rated R.
We came to the wrong war.
A one-eyed major and his oddball heroes fight a 20th century war in a 10th century castle. Castle Keep. The Falcon. The Dove. The Preacher. The Cowboy. The Count. The Mistress of the Castle. The Baker.
You're waking everybody up. Go back to your outfit.
We have no outfit. We don't believe in fighting.
Oh, who believes in fighting?
From the bold and bawdy novels.
Why you be a movie, doctor?
It was an international triumph. Burt Lancaster in Castle Keep.
Cataclysmic event in man's history. The eruption of the island volcano, Krakatoa, east of Java. Its thunder traveled more than 3,000 miles. Swells from its 50-foot tidal wave were felt around the world. Now the motion picture screen captures a spectacle to stun the senses. This is Krakatoa, east of Java. And these are the treasure hunters locked together in its fantastic adventure. Maximilian Schell, Diane Baker, Brian Keith, Barbara Worrell, and Sal Mineo. Krakatoa, east of Java, transforms history's most awesome event into the screen's most spectacular achievement. Rated G.
This is Agatha Christie's brilliant Belgian detective.
Monsieur Hercule Poirot?
Belgians, I always thought you were French.
Albert Finney is Hercule Poirot in Agatha Christie's most perfect crime.
Better touch nothing.
Murder on the Orient Express. Starring the greatest cast of suspicious characters. Lauren Bacall.
Monsieur.
Martin Balsam.
She did it.
Ingrid Bergman. Jacqueline Bisset, Jean-Pierre Cassel, Sean Connery, John Gielgud, Wendy Hiller, Anthony Perkins, Vanessa Redgrave, Rachel Roberts, Richard Widmark, Michael York. The who's who in the whodunit.
The murderer is with us now.
Murder on the Orient Express, rated PG.
Mein Kampf, the true horror of Hitler. Inside the Warsaw Ghetto. Inside the concentration camps of Adolf Eichmann. Every foot of film authentic. Mein Kampf. Mein Kampf.
Ich habe es!
foot of this film is authentic, with scenes from secret German archives. The Warsaw Ghetto. Mein Kampf shows what happened inside these walls, in films photographed and then suppressed by the Nazis themselves. The horror of Hitler and Adolf Eichmann, whose name fills today's headlines. And here, the men left to defend the Reich. Mein Kampf, the most shocking scenes ever presented. Every minute of this motion picture filmed as it was happening. Mein Kampf.
The acknowledged master of the unexpected, Alfred Hitchcock, thrusts you into his new world of suspense. Paul Newman and Julie Andrews find love in danger and danger in love behind Alfred Hitchcock's torn curtain.
Now you stay away from me. Don't talk to me. Go home.
But she had to know what was happening to the man she loved.
They found Gormick's body.
Won't you please take me home?
I'm sorry, I can't. It'll blow up.
This is Alfred Hitchcock. Torn curtain will tear you apart with suspense.
Paul Newman and Julie Andrews in Alfred Hitchcock's Torn Curtain in Technicolor.
To be brave and brutal.
Is it true you mercenaries will do anything for money?
What are you talking about?
We're going to pick up $50 million worth of diamonds.
They are mercenaries, the best in the business. War is their profession and their destination. Dark of the Sun.
Where were you? We waited for you.
A strike force of crack mercenaries fight the hottest battle in all the blazing hell of today's stripe-torn Congo. Rod Taylor, Yvette Mimieux, Jim Brown, Dark of the Sun.
Dreaded Secundas. Any intruder must die, even if he is Tarzan, for his newest companion in adventure.
How did you get here so quick?
I took a shortcut.
Tarzan, searching the forbidden jungle for a small boy lost years ago in the swirling rapids of the Conaduco River, still being sought by a daring team of American photojournalists.
Would you care to make a statement, Mr. Cheetah?
Tarzan, witness to the amazing king-making ceremony of the fierce Secundas, as two powerful brothers compete for their father's throne in contests of supreme strength and courage. Starring Mike Henry as Tarzan, crossing into forbidden territory to find a lad who has survived the wilderness for 6 years with only jungle beasts for companionship. Tarzan and the Jungle Boy, fighting to escape a savage land ruled by terror. A tribe to which a human life means less than nothing. Tarzan, battling alone against skilled warriors. Tarzan challenges the deadly spears of Africa's fiercest tribesmen in his new big screen adventure. And the Jungle Boy.
What was your first reaction when you received the news of your Nobel Prize?
No reaction at all. I was dead drunk at the time.
This is not on the Nobel schedule, Mr. Craig.
I think you should be prepared to make unscheduled flights, Miss Anderson.
Yours is not the only unscheduled flight, Mr. Craig. Clive makes many unscheduled flights into the maze of conflict and intrigue that lurks behind the private lives of each of the winners.
You look as though you ought to be in bed.
I accept.
And then we all disappear behind the iron curtain on this rowboat. And nobody will ever know the truth.
Now, may I have my dressing gown back? And my wife, perhaps?
I have nothing on underneath.
He's not kidding. He just came from a nudist convention.
I'm being followed by two men who are trying to kill me.
Original in a game played with carbon copies. The man's name is Frank Bullitt. The last thing in the world you'd ever take Frank Bullitt for was a cop. Steve McQueen is Frank Bullitt, a Warner Brothers 7 Arts picture in Technicolor, co-starring Jacqueline Bisset and Robert Vaughn.
His name is Quiller. What do they want of Quiller? What does Quiller want of them? This man knows, but he won't talk. Not ever again. What do they want of Quiller? What does Quiller want of them? The answer is in the Quiller Memorandum.
He's dead. Another colleague of yours took over from him, Kenneth Lindsay Jones.
Mm-hmm.
He's dead, too. He was killed 2 days ago. We'd like you to take over.
The Quiller Memorandum, a worldwide bestseller, hailed as the most exciting and suspenseful spy story in years, is now on the screen. And Quiller is a spy you can believe. Starring George Siegel as Quiller, Alec Guinness as Paul, Max von Sydow.
My name's October.
October, a name to match the man.
You need to relax.
Cold.
They work you too hard.
Bleak.
That boss of yours, what's his name?
Terrifying.
Open your eyes.
Begin your report, Quiller. Can you hear me? Begin it!
What do they want of Quiller? What does Quiller want of them? Senta Berger is Inga. Very beautiful. Very loving. Perhaps very dangerous.
I'm worried about you, you know.
No need.
Oh, yes, there is. I know what they're like. He's told me what they're like.
He knew them.
Yes. He knew them.
Where is he, this man?
George Sanders is the man in London.
Any news from Berlin?
Robert Helpmann is the contact. Stop. Go.
Move over, please.
Stay close to Quiller. In the cat and mouse world of espionage, you have to use any bait you can find, even if you're it.
If you're still undecided by dawn, we will kill you both.
What do they want of Quiller? What does Quiller want of them? The answer is in the Quiller Memorandum.
name's Bond. James Bond.
James Bond is back. In the biggest 007 adventure of them all. On Her Majesty's Secret Service, James Bond has a woman in his life, and her name is Tracy. Of course, James Bond has enemies. But if they think Bond is just going to hang around and let them take over, they're wrong. They're dead wrong. This time, they drop a mountain on him. On Her Majesty's Secret Service. James Bond, 007. On a racing bobsled. On a ton of dynamite. On one ski. Back comes Bond. Down comes the mountain. On comes the excitement. In the biggest 007 adventure of them all. Majesty's Secret Service, rated M.
The adventure of man from the beginning of time. Excitement that overwhelms the senses. The most powerful motion picture entertainment of all time. The Bible. In the beginning, the wonder of creation, the spectacle of the Tower of Babel, the terror of Adam and Eve after the first sin, the shame of Sarah and her love for Abraham, the delight and drama of the story of Noah and the Ark. Peter O'Toole, Ava Gardner, Stephen Boyd, John Huston, George C. Scott, Richard Harris are among the great stars who lived the adventure of the Bible in the beginning.
You are watching the most spectacular hijack in history, 1 second before it happened.
All units stand by on a double.
What's up, Z?
A train's been hijacked.
Millions have read it. Now you can live it. The taking of Pelham 123.
Nothing will happen as long as you obey my orders.
The city of New York is given 1 hour to come up with $1 million ransom.
You're out of your skull.
We'll kill one hostage for every minute you're late.
We agree to pay the ransom. Turn your clock off. The money has to be counted, stacked, tied, transported uptown.
We're just not going to make it.
Column 123 is in motion.
The passengers are dead ducks.
What do they expect for that lousy 35 cents to live forever?
It's the only driving up train.
The most spectacular hijack in history. The taking of Pelham 123, rated R.
Now, the biggest Bond sale ever. James Bond is back. In front. And all over the place. Thunderball. And from Russia with love.
My orders are to kill you and deliver the Lecter.
More thrills per minute. More girls per moment.
The things I do for England.
More excitement. More adventure. More everything. Two Bonds for the price of one. In the biggest Bond sale ever. Thunderbolt. And from Russia with love.
Billy Wilder, the man who gave you the apartment and some like it hot, now reveals the private life of Sherlock Holmes.
private life of Sherlock Holmes was anything but elementary.
I hope I'm not being presumptuous, but there have been women in your life.
I found her body quite rewarding, especially the palm of her right hand.
Midgets.
Client isn't Madame Valadon, it's the Imperial German government.
Holmes, I saw it. The monster.
It's getting closer.
The private life of Sherlock Holmes was anything but elementary. Rated GP.
We're gonna make 30. A mandatory retirement age.
Max Frost, elected president of the United States before he was 25. By that majority of the population, under 25.
King.
Wild in the streets. And God help you if you're over 30.
The Queen is receiving me! The Queen! Land where my father died!
Starring Shelley Winters, Christopher Jones, Diane Varsi, Richard Pryor, and guest star Ed Begley. Max Frost, who enjoys all the pleasures of his virile young years.
You give me the laws! Give me the power!
Wild in the Streets. Today, a challenging motion picture. Tomorrow...
Curtis as the Great Imposter in the true story that makes fiction seem tame by comparison.
Well, you can't be Ben Stone.
I can't.
An ex-army warden should be fat, 50, and ugly as sin.
The truth is, these men are all one. Ferdinand W. DeMera, a person still very much alive. Life magazine broke the story and called it The Master Imposter, an incredible tale. For the prison warden had himself served time. The Navy surgeon, cited for 19 operations, had never been to medical school.
What's that?
Now, sir, you want me to have that tooth out, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Either he's the bravest man I ever saw,
or else the biggest dang fool ever lived.
I love you more than ever, and... I must marry you now.
Catherine, I can't marry you now. I just can't. Hello, Father.
You know what happened to me? I met her. She just won't listen.
Father, please, do me one favor. Don't pray for me. Goodbye.
When this dead hand moves, the monster created by a man they called Mad is turned loose to strike terror into the hearts of men. To shock women into uncontrolled hysteria.
Elizabeth!
To prey upon the innocence of children. This is the story you've heard about, talked about. The spine-tingling, blood-chilling story that stunned your emotions. Frankenstein.
Don't touch that!
Saucers have invaded our planet. Washington, London, Paris, Moscow are key targets. The whole world is under attack. Can it survive?
Survivors of a disintegrated solar system. At this moment, the remainder of our fleet is circling your globe.
What do you want with me?
Arrange for your world leaders to confer with us in the city of Washington.
They set up an electronic screen. The artillery doesn't penetrate.
Never before has the screen reached such heights of excitement. Breathtaking spectacle. Hair-raising terror. See the saucer men's high-frequency disintegrator. See flying saucers travel thousands of miles in seconds. See great cities leveled by flying saucer monsters.
Russ, look.
The same kind of thing that's watched us since the beginning of the project.
People of Earth, attention. People of Earth, attention. This is a voice speaking to you from thousands of miles beyond your planet.
They're coming down to take over. They made that clear to us in the saucer.
To the best of our knowledge, my wife and I are the only ones left alive.
Faceless vizier, the death fight of the centaur on the griffin, the six-armed goddess of evil. The flying homunculus. Siren on a rampage. The duel with the vanishing sorcerer. The one-eyed centaur. Thank you. The Fountain of Destiny.
Fabulous production know-how of Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer to catapult you through time into a world that is yet to be. Every moment is a year, hurtling through the atomic wars of the future on an incredible excursion into the unknown. Is this the human race of the future? Or is this the Morlocks, fiendish creatures who live in a weird underground world? And the Eloi, the tranquil sunshine people, who the Morlocks dominate and maintain like cattle, luring them below with the hypnotic wail of the sirens.
Richard Carlson. I'm sure you'd all like to know something about the new entertainment miracle, Third Dimension, what it is, what it does. Well, the best way I can describe it to you is to tell you that It makes the screen absolutely real and alive. People, objects, landscapes take on a depth and a dimension such as they have in real life. And it has an added quality. Objects actually seem to come out of the screen, so real they almost touch you, creating the most dramatic impact that the screen has ever known. Coming to an incredible climax when a molten meteoric spaceship from another planet rushes out of the heavens right at you. Of course, these illustrations are only a pale suggestion of the real thing. It can't be described. It's got to be seen and experienced. And I must add that even without 3D, It Came from Outer Space is a picture that you'll long remember for its blending of science and fiction, for its eerie terror, and for its story of an invasion from another planet that's almost beyond imagining. I tell you, from its size and its appearance, this thing came from outer space. I even have reason to believe that there's some form of life in it. What do you want? What are you doing? Let me see you as you really are.
Alive today, who has survived millions of years of evolution without change, without passion, and without logic. It lives to kill. A mindless eating machine. It will attack and devour anything. It is as if God created the devil and gave him jaws. This is Universal's extraordinary motion picture version of Peter Benchley's best-selling novel, Jaws.
I just found out that a girl got killed here last week. And you knew it. You knew there was a shark out there. You knew it was dangerous. But you love your uncle swimming anyway.
Shark. We've got a panic on our hands on the 4th of July.
Is it true that most people get attacked by sharks in 3 feet of water, about 10 feet from the beach?
Yeah. What we are dealing with here is a perfect engine, an eating machine.
We're not only going to have to close the beach, we're going to have to hire somebody to kill the shark.
Bad fish. But I'll catch him and kill him.
Did you hear your father? Out of the water now!
The shark, swallow you whole.
You're going to need a bigger boat.
That's a 20-footer.
25. 3 tons of them.
Down it up. He's coming 3 footers. Don't screw it up now.
Don't wait for me. Now! Shoot!
Scheider, Robert Shaw, Richard Dreyfuss, Jaws. See it before you go swimming.
rated PG. Maybe too intense for younger children.
A beautiful, innocent girl on her honeymoon. Her passionate dreams of perfect romance turned into a living nightmare. For this sweetheart she married, the man she had loved, was merely the hollow shell for the invaders from outer space.
Bill!
Who would believe her? Who could help her through the flesh-crawling terror of this unearthly marriage when anyone she turned to could be one of them? Back of Notre Dame, the Miracle Man, the Phantom of the Opera. The world, fascinated and thrilled, called him the Man of a Thousand Faces. But what was the secret Lon Chaney hid behind his thousand faces? What was the mystery in his life? Now, for the first time, the true story, torn from his heart, comes to the screen. Starring James Cagney, magnificent as the fabulous Lon Chaney, master of the grotesque, the weird, the strange. And Academy Award-winning Dorothy Malone and lovely Jane Greer as the two women who made his life more astounding, more touching than any of his unforgettable roles.
I'll come to see you every week. Every week. I promise you.
You had me fired. Damn you!
Who are you?
I'm from the collection agency. I've come to collect my wife.
Gentlemen, science has agreed that unless something is done and done quickly, man as the dominant species of life on Earth will be extinct within a year.
Of the President of the United States.
Stay in your homes, I repeat. Stay in your homes. Your personal safety, the safety of the entire city, depends upon your full cooperation with the military authorities.
Yes, cities, nations, even civilization itself, threatened with annihilation because in one moment of history-making violence, nature, mad, rampant, wrought its most awesome creation. But born in that swirling inferno of radioactive dust were things so horrible, so terrifying, so hideous. There is no word to describe them.
We may be witnesses to a biblical prophecy come true, and there shall be destruction and darkness come upon creation, and the beast shall reign over the earth.
Yes, the earth, the skies above and the seas below, infested by swarms of nightmare creatures, crueler, deadlier than the armored giants of prehistoric eras. Here is a wild, headlong flight into terror as the desert erupts with the grim battle for survival. Here is a fear-frenzied moment of suspense
as mankind totters before a thing that multiplies faster than it can be killed. Here is a desperate plunge into the black depths of the earth, where human courage challenges the brute force, the slashing jaws, the poison fangs that guard the subterranean nest where the beast spawns its terrible progeny.
To all units, condition red, drain 267 is the target area. Repeat, condition red, drain 267 is the target area.
We could use?
No, we can't take a chance. It might poison the whole city.
Island, in this building, through this door, down this hallway, lies the most frightening experience of your life. Prepare yourself for They Came From Within. If you think you're not afraid of the dark, if you think you have a strong stomach, if you feel nothing can shock you, if you believe you've seen everything, if you say you don't scare easily, what are they? Raging demons that must be exorcised. Bloodthirsty creatures that must be killed. Or incarnations of absolute evil. They came from within. They possess men, women, and children. And drive them to acts of unbelievable horror. No one is safe from them. No power on earth can stop them. The only escape is death. They came from within. If this picture doesn't make you scream and squirm, you'd better see a psychiatrist. Quick. Rated R.
The stuff for which movies were made. Adventure to make you wonder if it's true while your eyes convince you that it is. Truly, the thrill of thrills. Don't miss it this time.
Killing vine with a human frame that creeps and kills. The terrifying horror of the dead, entombed for 200 years, that creeps its way back to terrorize the living. The terrifying horror of a dreaded man called Dr. Terror, who, with his deck of mystic cards, could foretell destiny. Dr. Terror's House of Horrors.
this gate, from beyond this portal, comes the spirit of a madman.
What in the name of God? What did he do to make this house so evil?
Murder, vampirism, cannibalism, drug addiction, alcoholism, sadism, mutilation.
How did it end?
If it had ended, we would not be here.
Not since Rosemary's Baby have you witnessed such a desperate struggle between good and evil. The living possessed by the dead, and the furious battle of exorcism. Pamela Franklin.
He's inside me. Even as I'm speaking to you, I can feel him just waiting in there to take over.
Roddy McDowell.
The house tried to kill me. It almost succeeded.
Clive Rebel.
I do not accept this. I do not accept this.
Gail Honeycutt.
Naked. Drunk. Fighting. Oh, please get me out of here. Please.
The spirits of the dead can indeed possess the human body.
Florence.
A nightmare within a nightmare. The legend of Hell House. For the sake of your sanity, pray it isn't true.
About the next attraction you will see at this theater. The picture is The Tingler, which I direct. And for the first time in motion picture history, members of the audience, including you, will actually play a part in the picture. You will feel some of the physical reactions, the shocking sensations experienced by the actors on the screen. I guarantee that The Tingler has more shocks per minute than my last film, The House on Haunted Hill. But don't be alarmed. You can protect yourself. When you see the picture, you will be told and remember the instruction how you can guard yourself from attack by The Tingler. And now may I show you a few scenes from The Tingler?
I say that if you were injected with this, you'd revert to a primitive anthropoid, physically as well as mentally.